Well, hello, God bless you. Bishop Patrick L. Wooden, Sr. here with my lovely wife, my darling, who has been with me. We've been married now, baby, for how many years?
39 years and 11 months.
39 years, 11 months, and in December, next month, will be our 40th year of marriage. And I thank God for her. Baby, I thank God for you.
And thank God for you, Bishop.
And we're here to wish all of you a very happy Thanksgiving. Yes. You know, the Bible says in Psalms 106 and verse 1, praise ye the Lord. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for his mercy endureth forever. And honey, I think you have a passage of scripture that came to your mind that you wanted to share with the people today.
Yes, Psalm 92, verse 1, it says, it is a good thing to give praise, to give thanks unto our God and to sing praises unto thy name, O Most High.
Amen.
God is good and he is worthy to be praised.
You know, that'll preach. I would take my text and title, A Good Thing. It's a good thing to give praises to the Lord because God is good and he's worthy to be praised today. And it is our sincere desire that you have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. You know, it's a little different this year than in past Thanksgivings. And this is one of the reasons why we've stressed over the years that it's not Turkey Day. It's not about a turkey. It's not about an article or item of food, but it's about giving thanks to the God of the Bible for his blessings and bounty toward us. The father of our country, George Washington, when he gave the proclamation for us to thank God on this day, it was because the Lord was faithful to this nation. And it's the goodness of God that America exists. It is the goodness of God that brought this country into existence. And it is God's goodness that is sustaining our country. Yes. And so we don't want this to be Turkey Day for you or Turkey Day us, but a day that's set aside to acknowledge the goodness of the Lord. And why is that so important today? Because we're living in a time in this day of COVID-19. Mm-hmm. We all know that the virus is real.
Yes.
People have lost loved ones as a result of it. People have been infected themselves. It has brought about real changes in society. But on the other hand, there are those who want to use COVID as an excuse to change our customs, to change our worship, to keep us from even giving thanks. In some places in California, before they closed the churches altogether, they restricted singing and tried to restrict clapping your hands and singing and preaching for fear that you may project something. And the same ones who wouldn't let the people sing and clap their hands was all right with having protests in the streets. Mm. So my friends, we're here today to say to you, and I don't want to get too, fighting these battles, but I want to say to you, make it a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving. And don't forget about how good God has been to you and to yours. You know, I thank God that I have my wife for Thanksgiving.
Absolutely.
I thank God that we have our children and our grandchildren.
Yes.
And honey, I want you to share with us a little, because this Thanksgiving will be special and different for you as well as for me and the family. And one way in particular, a wonderful lady who has been a part of all of our Thanksgivings.
Yeah.
This year will be watching us from on high because she's gone on to be with the Lord. And I'm speaking of your mother, Miss Coraline McNeil. How are you with approaching Thanksgiving with God having taken your mama home?
Well, it's been a journey. It's been difficult. I think about it every day. I think about just who she was and what she meant to us, and particularly in Thanksgiving, just this time of year where we're used to being around her, used to her cooking, just used to her presence, and just the thought that for the first time she is not going to be here. It is something that has weighed heavily upon me. But one of the things that as I pray about it, the thing that resounds in my spirit is the memories.
And to
thank God, you know, to see the glass half full opposed to half empty.
That's good.
And so half empty is that for the first time she's not with us. But half full is for 59 years she's been here.
That's right.
And so I am so grateful for the memories of my mom. I'm so grateful, and I've just purposed in my heart that I'm going to make it a great day on purpose.
Hallelujah.
Naturally, there
Glory
is that natural tendency to be sad, that natural tendency to be heavy-hearted. And so when I find myself in that place, and lo, I certainly have been in that place, but when I find myself in that place, I purposely move myself to another place. I purpose in my heart to think something good about my mom. I purposed in my heart to cook something that I know that my mom would have cooked. It's not going to be as good as it was when she cooked it. But that dressing nobody has been able to imitate, I'm going to try it tonight or today. I'm going to try it so that in her honor and in her memory. And
It's
going
to be good. You won't, if you miss it, you won't miss it by much.
So, you know, that's what I have done, you know, and I thank, you know, my family and my friends, you know, they certainly have been intentional about just saying kind things and, you know, just undergirding me during this time.
Yes,
and so that has certainly made a great difference.
Well, I'm grateful. And first of all, thank you for sharing that with our audience, because that's personal. And Ms. Carr was such a wonderful lady. I'll be honest with you. I think of her almost every day. You know, she looked out for me. If she would get a tip on anything that's healthy, she would call and say, tell Pat to take this, Pat to eat that.
Absolutely.
You remember when she got the word to me on walnuts?
Oh, yeah.
She said, tell Pat, walnuts.
And I bought some walnuts yesterday.
Good. I mean, look, if I were to get the tip, one thing about Patrick Wooden, I'll listen.
Yeah.
And especially if it's something good I can eat. But and I think of all the times where there are times when I miss certain family gatherings. Due to ministry or due to whatever. But you know what? She always sent me my plate.
Yes, she did.
She would fix my plate and send my plate to me, and I enjoyed it. And I think another reason to add to the reasons that will bring you a degree of joy tomorrow with regards to this is that she's with the Lord.
Absolutely.
To be absent from the body for the believer is to be present with the Lord.
Yes.
And I'm grateful, honey, that one of the things I'm most thankful for Thanksgiving is the gift of you. Because, you know,
God is good.
I mean, God is very good.
We have each other.
Yeah,
yes.
God's good. God brought you through cancer. You're free, and the Lord blessed and raised you up. And I thank God. I thank the God of the Bible for his bounty.
Yeah.
And how God blessed me. The Lord heard my prayer.
Yeah.
I can't talk. We start talking about giving thanks. I remember on the day of the surgery when I was good. I was good. I was strong. All the scriptures worked. Everything. All, you know, we all do things to keep each other, keep
Absolutely.
Ourselves strong. But when I had to walk out that room and leave you,
that was a tender moment.
That was, I think I might better change the subject. We're supposed to be, but this is one of the things I'm giving thanks for.
Absolutely.
Because I knew then that you're in the hands. Thank God for good doctors.
Yes.
Thank God for living in a country where there's great medical care. Thank God for great hospitals. But I always say this, with the finest hospitals, all of them have morgues.
Yeah.
And they're limited. It was the God of the Bible who brought you out. Yes. And you caught it in time, in
glory.
The smallest
possible form. Yes.
And that's something. Mm-hmm. And look at you, sitting there looking all pretty and fine and dressed up and mine and all that kind of stuff.
But to God be the glory. Speaking of that, I was a caption caught my attention on the news. It said, "Is there really anything to give thanks for this year?"
Mm.
And yes, my mom is gone and I will miss her. Yes, we have been in the midst of a pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we have been in critical times as they relate to race. Yes, we have gone through a presidential election like none other.
Mm-hmm.
And so the times are different. But I declare unto you, we still have so much to thank God for. The Lord
Amen.
Is good.
Good.
And he's worthy to
Amen.
Be praised.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. You know, that I'm hoping that that was a rhetorical question, whoever asked it, because you can't even count the blessings of the Lord. The Bible says in Psalm 106, verse 2, it says, "Who can utter the mighty acts of the Lord? Who can show forth all his praises?" Because there are so many things that the Lord has done, so much that God is doing, that no one can even adequately count their blessings.
Absolutely.
Much less name them one by one.
Yes.
I'm thankful to God that we have our children.
Yes.
And I'm thankful to God that we have our grandchildren.
Yes.
I'm thankful to God for my son-in-law.
Yeah.
I'm thankful to God that God has blessed me to have my mother.
Absolutely.
I thank God that
Miss
Gwendolyn Ellison, and mom's doing good, and I'm grateful to God for that, and my brothers-in-law, our family, and then the Upper Room Church of God of Christ family.
Sir.
Oh,
yes,
my
sir.
Lord.
Yes,
baby.
Sir.
God blessed us.
Yes, he did. He did. God is so
God
good.
Blessed us.
I do regret, because this is our first year without our mom, I do regret that because of the times that our family, my brothers and their families, we will not all be able to get together. But you know what? I am grateful that we're all in the land of the living.
Amen.
We're all healthy.
Amen.
My aunts and my cousins.
Amen.
So we do regret not being able to have that time. That's something that we have always done. We've always been together in some form, some way.
Yep.
Because of the Thanksgiving service, there have been times that we weren't able to go to our hometown on Thanksgiving Day, but we would always go that Friday. So we've always celebrated in some way or another. And so
Amen.
I do deeply regret that. But there'll be other times.
There'll
if
be other
it
times.
Be the Lord's will.
Yes.
Yes.
There'll be other times. And we love our families and we love the church family. And my friends, we love you. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your support.
Yes.
Thank you for how you are standing by and standing with this ministry.
Yes.
We've met new friends in social media there and just so many different places. I would love to just start naming some of the places, but I don't want to omit anyone. So I'll just say to all of you who have discovered this ministry, you believe in this ministry, you're praying for us. Thank God for you, and may the Lord continue to bless you. Now, we're excited. One of the things that we do, you mentioned it, on Thanksgiving is we have our big Thanksgiving Day service. The service starts at 10 a.m. and we walk out of the sanctuary at noonday. And God has given me the word of the Lord for our Thanksgiving Day service. And I want to invite you to be a part of that great service, God's going to move in a mighty way. As a matter of fact, it's on the tip of my tongue to kind of throw my title out, but I don't know if I should start doing that, Gary, because I generally don't do that. But you know what? You know what? I'm going to tell you what God has put on my heart. I'm going to talk about a defiant praise. Amen.
Ooh, praise the Lord.
Because the devil don't want us to have joy. He doesn't want us to be excited.
Right.
He don't want us to love the Lord and to enjoy praises and all that. But you know what? I'm going to fight to keep my praise.
Yes.
I am going to do what I have to do to keep myself in the right frame of mind. You know, you were preaching it earlier, and you didn't know.
Wow.
When you talked about how you shift, and when something comes to your mind, you intentionally don't stay there.
Yeah.
Girl, that's Bible.
Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Hey, that's where I got it from. The Lord. The Lord is the strength of my life.
Woo!
Yes, he is.
Good God Almighty.
So I want to encourage you to get dressed right now and make your way to the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. We are going to have a glorious time of celebration, thanking the Lord for his goodness, thanking the Lord for his bounty, thanking the Lord for his grace and for his mercy in times like these. You need to get out, you know, before we eat and before we sit and dine together. Come on out.
Amen.
And let's give thanks to the Lord first.
Amen. For he is good. His mercy endureth forever. So we'll see you in church here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. And just come. We're still exercising our best practices.
Yes.
We're still social distancing. We still take the temperatures. We're doing those things. If you, the mask mandates and all that, we're doing those things. But you come on out here and let's worship the Lord. And you know, we've been back here in our sanctuary for at least 28 or 29 weeks. And do you not know, my friends, we have not had any problems. God has blessed our efforts.
Thank you, Lord.
And I thank God for an intelligent congregation.
Yes.
Upper Room people are smart people. And we do things to keep each other safe.
Yes.
And to minimize the spread of the COVID-19 virus.
Yes.
And I want to thank God for such a wise congregation who works with us. So, my friends, we're coming to the end. And thank you for joining us for this little chat. I'm glad to have my lovely wife with me. She means the world to me, to me as a pastor, as a husband, as a father, as a lover, as an African American, as a male. Let me tell you, I can go down the list and start talking, and I feel my helper coming.
Well, I certainly do thank God for you, Bishop Whitten.
Thank you, baby.
You are an anointed man of God. You are an awesome preacher, but you are a husband second to none.
Did y'all hear
and
that?
I thank God that even
tell him,
through
baby, tell
the
him.
Years,
you tell him.
40 years in just, I think, a week.
Yeah.
December the 6th,
a little
more than a week, we will celebrate our 40th wedding anniversary. And one of the things that have made it possible is being married to a wonderful man like you. You've been a leader indeed.
Well, thank
you know,
God.
That's not to say that we haven't had troubles.
Amen.
We've had troubles.
Oh,
we've had difficult times.
Mm-hmm.
But it takes leadership. You know, the husband is the head of the home. Mm-hmm. He is the leader of the home when times are good and when times are bad. When times are bad, it is the husband's responsibility to lead us out, to lead the family through difficult times.
Amen.
And you have certainly been that type of husband and father and leader. And
I
thank God for you.
Well, thank you. Thank
you. Honesty
and
sincerity.
Well, thank you for those kind words. I'm moved, you know. I thank God for my wife. You know, we were just talking last night at the men's meeting, and we were talking about one of the sins that really hinders marriages, hinders problems, and that is hard-heartedness.
Absolutely.
Hardness of heart.
Absolutely.
Hardness of heart. You know, in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 19, now Gary, we're going off, I just want to mention this. It's always a sermon. But in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 19, Jesus heals an entire multitude of people.
Yes.
The Bible is clear on this. He healed everyone present. Now think about this, my friends. Everyone present got healed.
Wow.
Yet in the midst of him, his healing, everyone, we don't know how many thousands of people were there. Mm-hmm. He healed everyone. Did I say everyone?
Everyone.
He healed everyone. And yet while healing everyone, the Pharisees plan and they come up with a plot to try to ask him a trick question. Mm. And they said, is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for every cause? Now, even if I would have been a Pharisee,
right,
and had I been there and I would have been a part of the plan, after I witnessed him healing everyone, I would have quit. I told him, you know what? Jesus said, well, what do you want to ask me? Nothing. I've seen enough.
Absolutely.
I'm done.
Yes.
But if your heart is hard.
Right.
If your heart is hard,
if your heart is hard,
can see the glory of God.
Yes.
The blessings of the Lord, the power of God, but you still go with that hard heart.
Yes.
And they still tried to trick him. And what he did was he went to their motives and said the reason Moses gave a bill of divorcement was because of your hardness of heart.
Absolutely.
Your obstinate heart.
God.
Your unreasonable willingness to have it your own way.
Yes.
Your stubbornness, your unreasonable willingness to comply, to capitulate, to go along with, to work with. I thank God. I thank God for his word. And I want to say to you out there, don't let the enemy make your heart hard.
Absolutely.
We've made it thus far because we've surrendered our hearts to the Lord.
Absolutely.
Our hearts to each other.
Absolutely.
And I appreciate what you said about my being the head of the household, but I'm not the boss of the household. We
right.
work together.
Absolutely.
We work together.
Absolutely.
I honor your gift. I was sharing with the guys last night that there's just a multitude of things that you do.
Mm.
In our home and even in the ministry, but right now in the home.
Absolutely.
That takes the load off of me and that, quite frankly, that I'm not good at. And I can, since Pam's got this, she'll handle this. She knows how to handle it. And I thank you. I thank
Amen.
You. You know,
thank
you're a beautiful lady, but I'm glad God gave you a brain where you can help a brother out. So thank God for you. All right, my friends, meet us for our Thanksgiving Day service.
Yes.
We are going to give thanks to the God of the Bible. And I'm adamant. I'm defiant. I'm
yes.
pushing back. I'm adamant about giving God the praise.
Glory.
The praise. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
God bless you.